You can't have me on camera answering questions.
Can you?
No. Is it catching you off guard?
I gotta be prepared for this.
Caught off guard. I might need to fire up and get ready for this question right here, huh? What's it gonna be?
What's one thing no one admits about being a musician?
I would say no one admits about being a musician. Admit. Admits. No one admits. I would say maybe people do admit it, but I would say how much of an impact you can have on someone else as far as the words you say or the music that you're playing for them. It really means a lot to people. And then when they come up to you and they're like, I needed this tonight. Thank you so much for coming. Thank you so much for playing. That just really means a lot to me. It makes me want to keep playing and keep playing music. So,
let's see. Okay. Everybody thinks with being a musician, you're always going to like have an upper advantage with the opposite sex of some kind. Nobody tells you that the opposite sex, once they realize you're a musician and that you're always wanting to play gigs and go do everything but have like a date night, it's actually counterproductive to your personal life. You know what I'm saying? So you got to do it for the right reasons.
Sacrifice that it takes to do what we do on stage on such a regular basis, you know, whether it be like being away from your family or your friends or your loved ones, or, you know, we all have day jobs too. Sometimes, you know, you can't be everywhere at once. And I know as a musician, where I want to be is on that stage doing what I love, and it takes a lot to be there sometimes. So it's not always just fun and games.
I mean, I'm a very open person, so I may be the wrong person to ask, because I pretty much will just tell it how it is. I don't never really, I mean, sometimes you get privileges that other people don't get, but I think people may already know that. They may not know all the privileges we get, or, you know, maybe favors or things that people will do. You know, musicians as a whole have a tendency to draw people because of their energy and their vibe. So people want to do things for you when you have that energy. So that's all I could say. Because like I said, I just pretty much speak my mind. So it's, I don't hide it. I probably should hide more than I do, but I don't hide anything. It's all right here.
Long car rides and not driving over 80 miles per hour because your friend is the most stoniest guy, but you can't bring no flyer on the trip. Peace and love.
That you're gonna work a long time. Don't get in it for the money. It's not about the money. If you're getting in it for the money, you just stop now and play for fun. Because if you're not about it, for just doing it for the love of music, I mean, you're gonna be sorely disappointed, because it's a lot of hard work. You're playing a lot of shows for free. You're playing a lot of shows to seven people. And you still gotta bring the same energy and the same love if you love the music. So don't get in it for the money.
About how much luggage you got to carry up and down stairs all the time, and how much that wears on your poor feet and your poor back.
That dealing with musicians can be very, very difficult. But we love music so much that we are willing to endure the shit that musicians put us through. And in turn, we love them. So thank you, musicians, from the bottom of my heart.
Being fake. Don't be fake. There's a lot of fake people in this place. And just be you. Be real.
There's a lot of artworks in the music business, you know. And you know, as a reggae artist, you know, just come to sing about truths and rights, and you know, we're all about equality, you know. So you know, the music is bigger than us, you know. Yeah, man, really bigger than us. So we just have to full joy it and put the love in it, and you know, keep on doing what we're doing, the positive thing to uplift the next generation, you know, with positive music, you know, Rastafari vibration.
How little you actually get to see your family on tour is very slim. It's like when you go travel through the city, you get to visit them. So it gets pretty slim, but you know, it's all good. We gotta keep rolling. Making it work.
Here's the point of the question, they don't admit it. but I think I speak for a lot of them. I'm not going to say something like 100% or anything like that. The desire to want to be accepted, which obviously from whether it's a crowd of 10 people or 10,000, you know, I mean, I'm not speaking for anybody here. I believe there are people out there just, they're out for the music, and maybe when the crowd hates them, they either are indifferent, or like, well, I'm going to make it better, or just F them. You always want to hang out with people that are way better than you, the best person in the room, to the point where you're just analyzing and learning and looking at their hands or whatever they're doing. And then eventually, if the guitar gets passed around, like it did for me, acoustic, whatever, oh, you want to play something? And I'm like, well, not now. You guys are very, very cool. Try to learn so much and just surround yourself with the greatest people that you know, and always be kind. Up the Trees of Life in January of 2017, because, and by this time, all of the other band members knew it. They could see it, whether I didn't admit it. They're physically, apparently breaking down without a heroin addiction. No, it wasn't when I joined the band. Wait. The music, and I got a lot of family questions for this, but the music industry and the music business was not the cause of my drug addiction. Very important. Anybody understands that. When I joined the Trees of Life in 2015, probably April, let's say, I was already addicted to Oxy. I was on the, not like, this is not a, what do you call it? War story, and it's not a, glorifying exact. In fact, it's the complete opposite. You're in that point where you're at, let's say you have a show coming up. It's noon right now. We got a show coming up at 7, 8 p.m. Well, you have to have your drug just to freaking not be sick. I'm serious, not be sick. I've been clean for just over 4 years off heroin. And I work at a recovery house in Sanford. We house homeless veterans, and we house people that are addicted to alcohol and drugs, place to live while they work. Anyway, yeah. So I've been doing that for 4 years now, and I'm giving back. I love this shit. Just longer term musicians than me or guitar in college. Yeah, just humility and recognizing greatness, you know, and following your heart. Yeah, that's pretty much it. I got no skeletons in my closet.
What's something no one admits about being a musician?
You don't actually get to go back.
Damn, that it's more work than you think it is.
Nobody admits how lonely it is. Because when you go on a mission like this, it's really a solo journey. And if you expect people to, you know, want it as bad as you do, you'll be mistaken. And so set proper expectations and do not give up.
Ah, one thing nobody admits about being a musician, that it's very tough on the road, you know? The road is tough. I think that's the toughest part about being a musician is from night to night, you gotta go from city to city, stage to stage. Sometimes you sleep in a van, sometimes you're at friend's house, sometimes it's the luxury hotels and all that. But that type of vibe, I think that's one of the biggest areas, for sure.
Figure how much money and time it really takes to put into this. Like a lot of bands don't make any money like coming out to stuff like this. And you know, a lot of it's just about, you know, getting out there and meeting new people. You know, we came from Atlantic City, New Jersey. You know, our guarantee for the show basically covers us going there and back, and that's about it. Yeah, it's not as glamorous as people think it is. You know, we got 5 people in an RV. It's messy, stinks. You know, we're just out here grinding, and That's about it. Yeah.
All the shows that there's no one at. Oh, that's, I think that's the, you know, everybody likes to make it seem like it's all beautiful, you know? But there's many, many nights where it's just you and your friends in a dive bar.
This is the last thing. Oh, Max, I'm just sitting, he didn't make another trip.
The hardest thing about being a musician, I think the hardest thing might be just the decision that you're a musician, and then everything's easy, so you go chase it. The hardest thing is declaring yourself a musician, and so you should do that early and do that proudly, and you're a musician that is conquered whatever conquered.
You're the only kind of person that lives in your own heart the whole time. You have to accept who you are and deal with it every day.
What's something no one admits about being a musician?
You love to be a musician, don't you?
I know a lot of people don't make mistakes. I make mistakes. I make mistakes all the time. But mistakes make you a better musician once you realize you're making them.
Well, frankly, to be, straightforward, I don't want to be arrogant because, to be honest, I don't know what other people have to say about music, not everybody. But I do believe that music is an essential part of our well-being. And I think that music actually connects us with our souls. And our souls live on. That's why music never dies. And our souls can't die unless, of course, as I was taught, that the creator decides to do that. And I believe that music is our way of communicating, you know, communicating with our ancestors and also making that connection with ourselves. And also making that link to the future. And so music is one of the most powerful things I think that we were granted as human beings to have the privilege of sharing with each other.
Yeah, I just like to be a musician, you know, because being a musician, we get to broadcast the truth, yeah, and we get to get the people together, because that's what our mission is to gather people together with the music that carry the truth and carry the rights. So we here to break down the barrier with our music. That's why I like to be a musician, to break down the barrier, yes.
They don't admit how fun it's gonna be.
All right, what is one thing nobody admits about being a musician?
That we're thieves. As a lyricist, I don't just write about me, I write about everybody, my friends, people I've known, books I've read, so I steal ideas and stories from everyone, everywhere, to write lyrics.
What is something no one admits about being a musician?
Something that no one admits about being a musician. I think, I want to start with saying that when we create music, we're trying to create it to make ourselves feel better, make other people feel better, and also, you know, to make each other relate to each other and tell a story that, you know, we all have experienced, you know, something that's unifying. Music is supposed to be this unifying thing. And that's all good and all, but as a musician myself, at least me personally, I want it all. I want a large impact. I want to perform for large crowds. I want to make a footprint that lasts past the time that I pass away and go move on from this planet. I want to be in Madison Square Garden. I want to be in Central Park performing in front of 500,000 people all at once, world tours, as often as I want, just because that means to me that I'm doing what I set out to do. And I think we don't admit that as musicians because ego and overconfidence gets misconstrued with just being confident in yourself, you know? And I think that's something that we tend to not admit too often, but I think it's something that's very true for a lot of musicians, if not all artists, if not anybody, everybody. You know, everybody just wants to be loved and feel and know that they're loved, you know? I guess that's a part of it, why I want it all.
It's a good question. I think a lot of the times, most musicians honestly hold back on telling you how much they actually grind. A lot of musicians are not sleeping on the road, not eating as good as they should, but we're doing it so we can make it to the next show, play more shows for more people.
That they struggle to play.
That traveling sucks.
How much you can get burned out by playing the same songs over and over again, and it's hard because your best songs are the one that people want to hear the most, but you get pretty burned out on them and you have to keep going.
Probably that
it's hard work, and no one really wants to pay you well, but you want to have a good time anyways, so.
All right, what's one thing nobody admits about being a musician?
Nobody admits, I have no idea what I'm doing on stage. Let it roll.
I don't tell you about the beauty, seeing the smiling faces out there and changing people's lives. Like the most, probably my most favorite show was somebody coming up to me and telling me, hey, I was in the darkest time of my life, but because of your music, I decided to stay on this earth. And that's the beauty of being a musician.
Okay, so something that no one admits about being a musician is that the battle is really with yourself, self-doubt. And most times it's just perseverance that gets you success. So the battle is really with yourself. And if you persevere through it, you will find the success.
One thing that I'd say would be like, that no musician ever talks about is like having an identity crisis, in the sense of you're inspired by other people, but you don't want to sound like everyone, you want to sound like yourself. And so, something that no one ever admits, because obviously you're a product and you don't want to show someone what you sound like, you want to be you. But in reality, I think that's kind of where the emergence of an artist comes from, is realizing you're not who you want to be, and that's okay.
It's hard work. It's hard work, but it always pays off.
The fact that you can pay your bills, but you're living off ramen for the rest of your life, unless you absolutely just get lucky.
It takes a lot of practice if you really want to hit it hard. If you want to play well, you got to practice, right?
It is hard.
Well, hey, no, if you want to be good, you got to practice, right?
Yes.
I'm being serious.
Right? Nobody gets that.
I think something that probably a lot of musicians like really hate to admit, especially ones that like really, like myself, I make really positive music, get so much good, amazing energy, and like it's the greatest job in the world. And I think probably the hardest thing to admit is that like every once in a while it feels just like any other job. Like you're not always like super jazz to like, you know, make it to the gig, and it's like an incredible amount of hard work sometimes. And sometimes like on tour, you know, it's like, you know, do the show and talk to hundreds of people and like have this amazing experience, and then like get home super late, and you know, get back to the hotel super late at like 3 a.m. and then have to wake up at 5 a.m. to get on the road again, and it can be rough. And I think like you know, it's hard to admit that sometimes it's just like, you know, it's like a grind. It's a, you know, and I don't want to admit it to myself sometimes. And it, you know, it feels like, I guess it feels like I should be like just 100% like overflowing with gratitude always for it. And then like, there's, you know, a human part of me that sometimes is just like, I just want to lay in bed and not go to the gig tonight, you know? But always, you know, but that being said, always when I do make it to the gig and I make it on stage, like, it's always amazing. There's never been a show where I was just like, this sucks, you know? The show is always amazing.
That is really just magic over magicians.
It's hard to say, because I've heard people say it in the scene, but personally, what I think we don't publicize is all the agony and trauma and the anxiety and all the mental issues that basically every artist has. Because all of us artists are really tortured souls. We go through things, and our outlet is music and writing. And when we feel normal is when we're around a whole bunch of people that feel the same way. And I feel like that's not vocalized enough, that we're all depressed. Every one of us is depressed, and this is our release. So I feel like that is it.
You'll put your all into it. You know, you really put your heart out, you bleed it out on stage. People don't always reciprocate what you're putting out. You know, so sometimes, you know, you feel like you're getting a knock, and you're like, wow, they really don't get it, or they didn't appreciate, or not enough people showed out. But as long as you stay true to yourself, keep your music pure, don't fuck around, stay off the hard shit, you'll be fine.
It's way more fun than you think it is.
How badly the airlines want to smash up your instruments by putting them under the plane instead of letting you take them with you and put them in the overheads.
That it's very encompassing and uncomfortable at times, but the best part of it is that when you're successful, everybody's happy.
What's something no one admits about being a musician?
Pay sucks. No? You get paid shit.
That it's a lot of fucking work. I
think that nobody admits personally how much money it takes to get to the top and to get to where you want to go collaboratively.
That you gotta fake it till you make it. Most of them. Unless you're real. And then you don't have to fake it, you know?
Honestly, half the time I'm winging it.
No one's gonna tell you that playing on stage is only 5% of being in a band.
That you don't just have to be a musician. You have to be a musician and a driver and a loader and a planner and a friend. And you gotta be, you gotta go and see every town in the world in America, and they're all the same, but there's cooler ones than other ones. Here's some Myrtle Beach, it's pretty cool. But that's about it. That's all I got.
One thing no one admits about being a musician is when they're wrong. Because every musician always thinks that they're right. But, I mean, a lot of times you can still be wrong and nobody will ever know the difference. It's all on how you interpret the music. So you just got to take it as it comes. How to actually get up in front of people, talk to them, and not be shy and get rid of my stage fright. Because when I first started, I couldn't talk to anybody and I could hardly pull my instrument out in front of people unless it was really small crowds. And I still get stage fright to this day, but it's helped me learn to grow and actually be able to express myself. And I've been able to push my boundaries to become a better person and a better musician because of it.
Oh man, the long drives to gigs for the low payout sometimes. You know, the late nights and all that.
Well, probably how shitty their car is most of the time. Because all the driving really, really takes a toll on it. And you gotta be honest about it sometimes. Be like, yo, maybe you can't make it to that gig. But you gotta say yes to the gig and hope that your car actually fucking makes it. So, it's tough to admit that sometimes your car is a fucking piece of shit when you really need the gig.
The struggle that one faces, and not only with others in the scene or whatever, but within yourself. I think there's a constant struggle. A lot of us use it as an outlet, and sometimes it can get really rough, getting really raw about your feelings and things like that, if you're being expressive with your art. And so, yeah.
And I would say that the one thing that most musicians don't admit to is that they're super self-conscious secretly. I feel like at least most of the musicians that I know are that way. And we're like, very self-critical to the point where we're uncomfortable playing in front of people, but most people don't realize it.
You're gonna face the people that doubt you head on, like the fiercest creature on the planet. But at the same time, you have to be warm and fuzzy, like a little furball, for everybody to love and want to be near. And you can't let people push you around, but you also gotta be really nice. Doesn't
but it always takes practice, everything, even the littlest things, you know. If you don't practice it, it's not gonna show itself. So a lot of people don't talk about every little thing, you know. A musician really takes care of themselves, takes care of their friends and their family, and you know, definitely takes care of the music.
Well, for me personally, I need space. Space to get creative, you know. It's kind of rough being around people all the time, especially when you live with a family. So for me, solitude is something a lot, you know, you see artists and musicians always around people, but a lot of people don't know, they like quiet time, we like quiet time. You know, when we have quiet time, we can reach out to the stars and get inspiration and get creative. So quiet time is a must.
That musician also could be a good cook.
Sometimes it's not as fun as you think, I would say. It's a lot of, you think it's so cool, you get to this one place, you set up at 2 o'clock, and then you wait for sometimes 6 hours before you play. And I don't think a lot of people, sometimes it's hard to find stuff to do in towns around the area, you know what I mean? And you can't go too far because you don't know when they're gonna call you back. So it's, a lot of it is just hurry up and wait, you know what I mean? And it kills me sometimes because I'm so eager, especially to go up on stage. We're next and I'm just eager to go do it, but I gotta wait, you know what I mean? So.
Probably about how much time they spend doing it alone before they do it with other people. I think a lot of musicians practice a lot. They don't want to admit how much they practice.
Well, sometimes it gets, it just becomes like everything else in life. If you don't put enough passion into it, it becomes just another thing. It kind of becomes just work. It just becomes just kind of like a burden if you don't treat it right. You know, it's like if you don't write any new songs, you're stuck playing the same songs for years. If you're, you know, stagnating, then it can be kind of a burden on you where you, you know, feel pressure to perform or to create. And yeah, that's something that most people don't know. They think it's all just fun and partying, but it's also a lot of hard work. I probably spent 10 years, you know, playing in my bedroom before I ever thought of jamming with somebody, you know, else, and actually, you know, putting myself out there. I was very shy, and a lot of shy people do play music. That's another thing. I think everyone who plays music is very outgoing, but a lot of people are kind of more introverted, just kind of keeping themselves, and when they come on stage is when they come alive, you know, and they become another version of themselves, kind of, so, yeah.
No one realizes that it's 80% off the stage, 10% on, well, 20% on, but 10 of it is, you know, it's, some weird combination of business / art, you know, it's nuts. So as much fun as it is to play music, you have to do a lot of shit that has nothing to do with music. That's what people don't realize. And one thing no one admits is that they all have their own agenda and they don't really care about anyone else. I'm kidding. Kind of. As I was saying, if you don't have a personal agenda, if you don't have some selfish interest to propel yourself to higher and higher heights, you really don't belong here, right? Because as much as of a community it is, everyone is definitely out to make their own waves in the world. And it's important as an artist, I think, to differentiate yourself. So it's hard. You gotta be a community, you gotta work together, you gotta uplift each other, but at the same time it is a competition. And that's the hard truth.
What's something no one admits about being a musician?
How loud it is after you get off stage, and you kind of need a second, a moment, to regulate back to your like regular motion of hearing. And on, no matter if you have in-ears or everything, in-ears do help, but depending on the crowd especially, the crowd is so loud and I love that. But it's hard to have a conversation or someone asking you a question as soon as you walk off of the stage.
People in the music industry have mental health issues. I suffer from anxiety, depression, ups and downs, highs and lows, and I feel like a lot of my coworkers and my bandmates deal with the same thing, but no one wants to talk about it. They just kind of mask it with drinking, or they just pretend like it doesn't exist. But I think the more we talk about it, the more we can be there for one another and figure out other ways to cope with it.
That we put in a lot of work, sometimes we don't. It may take months to practice, sometimes it may take a day, sometimes we might not even have practice, we just have to go straight into the gig without practicing, all meeting new people and playing right there in the spot.
One thing challenging that no one admits that could be a life of a musician is that it isn't as glamorous as it seems. Tour life, you know, late nights and eating foods and none can be the can be very hard as well. And it's a difficult path as well to admit, to stay on it, because you see many great musicians struggling and you see their the end of their lives, they're amazing musicians, but they're not landing in a good spot. So I guess my true resume, Olivia, it isn't as glamorous as it seems.
I think there's kind of a misconception that like when everyone sees us on stage really happy and enjoying everything, that means that we don't have any bad days or we don't have any quarrels with our brothers and sisters up there with us. Being in a committed band is a lot like being in several very tight relationships. So you're gonna have good days with one person and bad days with another person. But at the end of the day, you have to get up there on the stage and make everyone happy. And sometimes that can be a struggle, because if you're not feeling good, if you're not feeling good with a bandmate, it can be really tough. But I have to tell you, it's also one of the most rewarding relationships you could have, is to have bandmates that you work with and travel with.
So being a musician, most of the time you have to find odd jobs because you're constantly on the road. You can't have a specific place that you're working all the time unless you get something that they're willing to do that with you. But most of the time it's very hard. It's a very hard hustle because you're not making money 100% from your job. You are mainly working odd jobs to make ends meet. And my name is Anthony, and I'm the singer of Capistan.
I think one of the biggest things for me is the exchange of energy between the crowd and us. I've had a lot of really profound interactions that, to some degree or another, changed my life for the better. I think that really goes like kind of under the radar for a lot of people. Don't really realize how much between us and the audience it's like an exchange, and we both feed each other throughout the course of the show, a tour, whatever it is. It's, you know, it's definitely something that I've noticed, and it definitely feeds me.
No one admits that some musicians don't drink and do drugs.
Oh wow, they were all raging alcoholics.
Probably it's not as glamorous as it seems. It's definitely a lot of grinding, and pretty much you travel all these places and you're like, oh, I'm traveling, but really you're just seeing like the dumpsters and the back alleys of like all these states. But it's beautiful, we love it, it's fun, we do it for the fans.
Oh shit, it's lonely. I know that's kind of like I took it a dark turn, and sometimes you could take it positive. That was also maybe too quick of an answer, I feel like. Yeah, I mean, I feel like you hear about it like in like comedians all the time, where they're like, yo, yeah, I mean, you shut that door and you're like kind of alone at the end of the day. I mean, the amount of times we spend like scrolling on our phone or like napping in the green room, you know, it's incredibly exhausting, but it can get, you know, really, really lonely. I mean, you take a nap, imagine this, right before the set, you get up, you stretch, you warm up your voice, and then all of a sudden you're just like, you just gotta turn on. And that can be really exhausting, and especially if you're throwing meet and greets in there and you're throwing all this stuff. For a lot of people, like introspectives, introverts, I would say I'm probably more of an extrovert, but like still you need that time to recharge. And thankfully on the tour you can get that time, but a lot of times there's so much pulling at you that it can be really exhausting and can end up being like a little lonely. So that sounds, you know, it's obviously a small price to pay for what is so beautiful. The fact that we get to live our dreams, the fact that we get to literally just like hold a guitar or a piano or a bass, whatever it is you play, and that is the way you eat food and live your life. Like, come on, it's not that much to complain about. But I would say maybe that's the one thing that like maybe is easy to overlook. People think it's all glamour and all fun, and you know, it can get tough too. Hey, if one of your favorite bands doesn't want to party after the show, do not take it personally. They probably just need some personal time, some time to recharge, because think about it. They got to do that 60 nights in a row, whereas for you, it's just one night to party. So I don't know. It's, I think, thankfully, with like mental health stigma and all that stuff, I think it's becoming more apparent that like artists are people too. They need time to chill too. So I don't know. Loneliness, exhaustion, it's a thing you don't really hear much about, but it exists.
Being in the music industry, it can be a little bit rough and tricky at the same time. So you have to be aware and know who you're working with through your research, because it can get, you know, yeah, that's what I have to say.
I don't know if it's, no one admits it, but it's not as talked about as a lot of people think. But as far as just performing, it's a lot less glamorous than a lot of people think that are not in the industry. They think, oh, you must have all these opportunities to talk to women, to talk to girls, to set up these things, to hang out, to party. But it's a lot of work. It's a lot of work loading in. A lot of times during set breaks, we're talking about our set list, or, you know, people doing requests. And like just the other night, we studied up a cover during set break so we could play it the following set. And then usually by the end of the night, when you're free and packing up, usually the bar is closing or they send everyone home. And so any cute girls or anything that you saw throughout the night are usually gone by that point. So I would say overall, it's less of a glamorous lifestyle than a lot of people think.
Huh. No one admits that without music, you know, there would be no world. That's what I think. People don't admit it, but music, I think, is what drives the world, you know? So a lot of people don't admit it, but I think it's, without music, the world would not go wrong. I might not be sitting here without music.
Ah, man. What do you mean? It's all been said, you know? It's heartbreaking. I don't know if anybody ever told me that. I heard somebody allude to it once, and it happened to be somebody really, really close to me. And so it almost felt like it was my idea. So I'm gonna use that as my answer. Even though, to be honest, it wasn't my answer. I'm giving you somebody else's answer. I'm co-opting it. But it's heartbreaking. And I don't know that you see it that way, because it's so fulfilling, and there's so, you know, so much to it about being creative and making things up out of your brain. That heartbreaking is kind of the last, I don't know, it's the last thing I would have thought that I would feel as often. But, you know, good luck. Figure out how to write that perfect song. Good luck. And none of us are gonna do it. There's like four people that get to do it. And the rest of us will keep just trying and trying and trying.
Oh man, what's someone that no one admits about being a musician is that you're like, honestly, I mean, maybe people admit this, maybe people don't, but you're never like fully satisfied. And it sounds like kind of like ungrateful to say that you're never satisfied, but like when it comes to your art, it's like people that do this like for life, like art, I don't think there's ever like a satisfaction. You just keep chasing like a fulfilling feeling, but it never really ends up feeling perfect. So you just have to just trust the moment and time of where you're in and just go with that. It's never gonna be. You can only strive for perfection, but nobody's perfect. That's my answer.
Something people don't know about being a musician is that we're basically truckers, because we live at truck stops. So we're basically truckers.
That you spend the whole day waiting to play music, and then you only play, you spend 23 hours waiting to play on tour and then only 1 hour playing music. Most of being a musician is waiting.
That it's hard to eat vegan.
What's something no one admits about being a musician?
It sucks. just kidding.
I need that Jeopardy minute.
Love you all, thank you.
Something no one admits about being a musician. All the gas station burritos that you eat. Late nights, Wawa's, Sheets, you name it. Bucky's. Bucky's down here in Florida, I stopped yesterday. Gas station burritos.
You have to love it. Gotta love it.
What's something no one admits about being a musician?
I'd say that it's harder than people think it is. Like, everybody always just sees the live show and the excitement and the performance, but they don't understand everything that goes on behind the scenes. So it's tough, you know, driving hours between the different venues, the different shows, and it's tiring not knowing where you're gonna sleep every night, sometimes like where you're getting food. So it's tiring, it's a grind, and people don't realize, like, when the bands pull up to the show, they're usually exhausted, but we come out and give it our all every night, and it's all worth it in the end. But I think a lot of the behind the scenes stuff and that kind of like that grind that goes into it is what a lot of people don't understand.
How difficult and expensive it could be to potentially put out the product that you want to put out the way you want it to be put out. That's something that I can think of right there.
I guess it's not always parties and drinking and women like it looks like. It's a lot of time spent alone working on your music and your craft, and I'd say it's not as flashy as it looks on social media.
Oh my gosh. Sometimes it's not as glorious as it seems.
I don't know, that's so hard. Maybe like the music they listen to, or oh, for me, I have like a nervous tic before I go on stage. I kind of like to go in the corner and just, you know, kind of be weird and, you know, kind of get the jitters out. I don't know.
Probably the amount of time that you have to invest into your craft is what you put into it is what you get out of it. So invest the time, quality time, on the right stuff.
I'm not sure if I would say that no one would admit it, but perhaps some people aren't as tuned in to the fact that music chose them for a reason, that music is not just something for entertainment, it's an energy that is a far higher vibration than what we have experienced growing up in a system that constantly tries to lower our vibration through each and every way it possibly can. And I think that perhaps some are yet to fully realize the multi-dimensional power of music, of sound, of intention in that music, of intention in that strum, in that kick, in that beat, in that word, in that lyric. These things are what creation is made of. So when we sing, we're singing new worlds and new realities into existence. And when we play music, we're elevating not just our cellular frequency, but we are vibrating and sending that out into whoever is around us and beyond. We don't even know how far it goes, but we know that music is magical, music is special, music is vital to life and existence on earth. So keep tuning in, keep tuning in deep, and pushing forward those positive frequencies.
Something that no one admits about being a musician. There's a lot of more business involved than the music. You know, if you want to do it for a living, it takes learning a lot of stuff that you. If you play music for the fun of it, you got to learn a lot of other stuff just to have fun.
Something that no one admits about being a musician. How challenging balance is within this lifestyle. It's important to put up a specific front, essentially, an image, because that's what people are there to see. But the sheer level of challenge and endurance necessary to survive and to maintain a career in this industry is
not something most people understand. So I would say that that's not something that's spoken about openly, but it's definitely a reality in the industry.
The level of stress we may induce because we're not really making a lot of money and we have to sacrifice a lot to put our art on display. So people may think that we are have these lavish lives where we have nice stuff. I drive kind of a crappy car and I live kind of in a small apartment, but I am living and thriving, so that's where the rewards kind of reap, I believe. I am my own boss 100%. So I think not a lot of artists talk about that stuff, you know. I think they want to look like they have a lot of cool stuff going on, when really it may not be so in a lot of cases, I think. So that would be my number one.
What's something no one admits about being a musician?
Something that no one admits about being a musician? Oh damn, you're getting serious. God. Man, you're stumping me. You're stumping me. What does no one admit? What did you say?
Short answer, long answer, it could be a one answer, it could be a story.
Something that no one admits. Oh yeah, I guess the horrible bathrooms that we have to use all the time. Yeah, I mean, I guess that's a good one. I mean, that's real. Like, we do not live in luxury when it comes to bathrooms at all. So there you go. There you go. Right?
Yeah. Oh yeah, dude.
I feel like I can speak from my perspective, because. But I feel like a lot of people see the performance, they see the music videos, they see all of that, and they don't see the work that it takes that goes into it. They don't see the self-motivation that it requires, that they don't overstand the self-motivation that it requires to push through and to persevere. And I think oftentimes, and there's nothing wrong with everyone doing it their way, but oftentimes that is a part that gets lost in translation at some point. People see the glitz and glamour and they feel like, oh, this is what it is and that is what I want. But they do not see the workings and the tickings behind it. And I feel like a lot of musicians don't do that for whatever reason, you know. But for me personally, that is definitely one thing I feel musicians don't really talk about. Yeah, good question, Sasha.
Much harder than it looks, that's for sure. It's much harder than it looks, and it's not as glamorous as it looks either. So yeah, that's something that a lot of people don't admit. It's a lot of hard work, a lot of patience, a lot of perseverance.
You spend like hours upon hours upon hours upon days to play like half an hour every night for like 3 weeks straight. That's it. All of this time for just a little bit of payoff.
90% of your meals are going to come from gas stations.
It's not nearly as glamorous as you think it is. No matter how big you get, you're still about one step away from being a homeless person when you're on tour.
Oh my goodness.
You're going to sleep in a lot of weird places. That's one that comes to mind.
What's something no one admits about being a musician?
You're going to be poor for a long time. You can't do it about the money. You can't be about the money.
I don't know about admits, but something that most people maybe don't know is that when you start playing music, you do it for fun. And you do it because you're with your friends and you want to play a kind of music that you love. And if you're lucky, then at some point you start actually paying some bills off it. Then if you're really lucky, you can quit your job and do music full time. But then something happens that you don't realize until it happens, which is if you're not careful, it becomes a paycheck and it's a job now. So you took the one thing you love and now it's a job. So the thing you love is now gone. So part of the key that I think everyone has to figure out eventually in music is how to keep being in love with it while doing it for a living. Does that make sense?
Something no one admits about
One thing that musicians don't really admit is it is not as glamorous as you may seem. Can I do it again?
more.
Okay, okay. You, will you ask the question? Because I can't.
Yes.
Okay, okay.
Let's do it again. What's something no one admits about being a musician?
One thing would be that it is not as glamorous as it seems. It takes a long, long, long time to get to the next step.
Being a musician, I think what a lot of people see when they want, they see a lot of the glamour and fun. They don't see the hard work and the dedication. They don't see what showing up to shows when there's 3-5 people in the crowd, like. But I think, you know, it's just being, it's staying true to your passion and staying true to your calling, I guess. Like, we've been together as a band for about 12 plus years, like going on like 13 or 14, but I think what kept us going, or what keeps us going, is just staying together.
Love you, buddy.
Calling bands like this, touring with bands like that, and the family vibe, and we're just, I think that's what gets unnoticed, is the extra hours, you know? I mean, that's the answer you get with the off-guard question.
That's a good question. The dedication, the consistency behind stuff. You can't just, like, you know, just do one thing and think it stops there. It's about consistency. It's most definitely reality. You understand? Everywhere I go, you know what I'm saying? I know people. You end up meeting the greatest of people. For anything that you may cater to in your everyday lifestyle, you understand? So it's spontaneous, but this is reality. It was 2 years that we were off of tour for because of the pandemic, due to the choice of our own. We wanted to play it safe, you know what I'm saying? But now that I'm back into the swing of things, this is our first festival or so that since we've been back on tour. And man, let me tell you, it's like it's never left. It's like, yeah, you see this person, hey, what's up, man? How you been? Hey, what's up? You know what I'm saying? It's just real, like, how can I put it? Like, this is you. You know people. You be, and when you tour, this is another thing. When you tour, like I said, you're gonna run into people in all sorts of shapes and sizes and mindsets in life. You know what I'm saying? You're gonna come across weirdos, you're gonna come across like good-hearted people, you're gonna come across some assholes sometimes too, you know. You come across all walks of life, you know what I'm saying? So, like I said before, it's reality. And if you ever get into this in this field, you're definitely gonna see some shit that you're gonna wanna write a book about. Or if you didn't even think of it, you should, because it's like you're gonna see some shit like, what the fuck? You know what I'm saying? You're gonna come across some stuff like that, maybe once or twice, or maybe more. That's me. I said it.
Something no one admits about being a musician.
The thing about it is something nobody admits, but a lot of people think that bands just come up out of nowhere. But the reality is they've been grinding at it for 10 years, and it just seems like that. You know what I mean? So I think that'd probably be my answer. So everyone's out there grinding, and we just put in so much work, you know, to get to what we want to do. But it's an amazing lifestyle. I'm definitely thankful for it. Yeah.
Name and band.
My name is Mike Nivens, and I play guitar for a band called Ajava, based out of St. Petersburg, Florida.
Something no one admits about being a musician.
Something that no one admits about being a musician? Something that no one admits about being a musician is that we love the VIP. The VIP is why we're really here. Something we really don't want to admit is that we all have anxiety. So we all want to be back here because that gives us, you know, a little buffer. That's what no one wants to admit. Yeah, kind of came on the scene. Yeah.
What's something no one admits about being a musician?
Okay, so my name is Al. I'm the lead singer and guitarist for the band, reggae band Earth Cry. And the one thing I would say that people don't admit about being a musician is that it's hard as hell, and you spend a lot of years broke before you actually start to make money. It's serious. doesn't get more real than that.
What's something no one admits about being a musician?
I don't know, because I think most people admit everything, you know what I mean? So I guess, like for us, being away from families or loved ones is the hardest thing. Sometimes you have to make a decision between family and your career. Sometimes you can cost your family. If you don't know how to balance it, you can cost your family. So I think that's one of the things that people kind of overlook, you know, the sacrifice you make of being away from your family. Yeah, so.
What's something no one admits about being a musician?
Well, before getting that big break, you get ignored a lot and you struggle financially. That's it.
What's something no one admits about being a musician?
I don't want to say not admit, but for me personally, a lot of people don't believe when I tell them this, that I have terrible stage fright and I'm absolutely terrified to perform every time. It doesn't get better. I've been doing it my whole life. It's my job, it's what I do for a living. I don't have a day job, I never have. But every time I get on stage, I am scared to death. And when I try to share this with people, it's a bummer in a way because they don't believe it, so they won't really share the experience with me. They're just like, no, no. So there's my secret, my hard thing about music.
What's something no one admits about being a musician?
The thing that no one admits about being a musician is that I feel that we're all insecure, egomaniacs, want to make ourselves feel better by making other people feel better. Through that, they like us. We, you know, by making them happy, we make ourselves happy. Insecure.
What's something no one admits about being a musician?
I think it's the relationship between the audience and the musician. Like when you're playing, that like symbiotic energy exchange that happens when you're playing music and like you're giving all this out, and when they give it back to you, that's like what makes it happen. That's the one of the coolest things about it. And maybe, I don't think people talk about that all the time, or like it's hard to understand, maybe. I think that's my thing, yeah.
Something no one admits about being a musician.
Something that no one ever admits, it's all about the t-shirt. You gotta have the right t-shirt on stage. I mean, that's everything, that's it. End of story, mic drop.
Something no one admits about being a musician. Be a short answer, long answer, or personal story and your journey as a musician. Something that you want your audience to know, what goes on behind the scenes of a musician in a musician's life.
My name is James Searle and I play with the band Giant Panda Gorilla Dub Squad. I think that something that nobody knows about being a musician is that it's a part of, if you feel music and if you're kind of, if it comes naturally to you, you know, some people are dancers, moving with their bodies comes naturally, you know, some people are builders, some people are painters, but like music people are dealing with this non-physical kind of vibrational thing that is being capturing like time. So it's kind of a big step into time travel, and it's one of the only arts I think that you can really like kind of get into that time space thing. And I think that something that people don't understand is that for somebody that is working in that medium, it's very much part of their personality, and if they don't do it, if they're not connected to it, it's like a certain part of them dies and they might not even know it when it happens. And you only realize it when like you come back and like the music wakes you up. You hear like a song that you love, or you know, it's like you realize that, oh, that's the tribe that I'm from. I'm from the music tribe, and it's part of me. It's part of, you know, part of what I'm supposed to do. So I feel like a lot of any musician kind of feels that way. If they've tried and worked hard to try to connect to their craft, try to connect to that time travel kind of practice, and they understand that it's kind of like a living part of their biological being. Have to do it vibrationally speaking.
That's what I got. All I got.
You know, nobody admits when you're a musician. I think what your top goal is, I think sometimes people, they strive for things, right? And they're afraid of failing so often. And I think it's really hard for people to admit their own potential and humble themselves constantly, because people around them are either telling them that, like, cool down, you know, don't get too excited about your success, or you're just not good enough. And those two polars keep people kind of stuck in this limbo. And don't feel afraid to admit your true potential, because so many musicians get stuck thinking that they either have something that they don't or want something that they don't have. So again, thank you for asking me this question. I'm Eli. That was my best answer. That's all I got.
So the question was, what can a musician tell you that other people don't understand? It's the amount of time that I put in on stage, physically being on stage. What you consider a 13 or 14 hour day is what I usually do in like 3 hours. It takes complete concentration, completely in the public's eye. You can't miss a note, you can't miss a feeling, you can't miss anything. And it's usually people that aren't inclined to being able to do normal activities that end up in this position as a musician, which is interesting because it makes us push basically our boundaries as, you know, people. And yeah.
One thing that nobody admits is, or you know, I kind of look at it as like no one wants to admit, is that it takes a lot of really, really hard work. You know, sometimes I wake up and I'm like, fuck me. You know, I don't want to play, I don't want to practice. And there's a sixth element that makes you, me as a drummer, grab my sticks and like just play music. Even if it's, you know, right, left, right, right, left, right, left, left. You know, drummers will understand that. But at the end of the day, it's a drive that you have to dig really deep for. And sometimes you really don't want to do it. But at the end of the day, it's a hell of a lot better than working a 9-to-5. And that's what keeps me going. So one thing that I think musicians don't want to ever admit is it's hard fucking work. But we love it. And I'll enjoy every second that I'm alive.
What's something no one admits about being a musician?
That every musician farts on stage.
What's something no one admits about being a musician?
No one admits that us musicians will actually play for free, but we really like to get paid for what we're doing too.
One thing no musician really wants to admit is that when everyone's smiling on stage, somebody messed up.
What's something no one admits about being a musician?
That every musician, at one time or another, will forget their own lyrics. It's just it. You know, sometimes it just falls out of your head and you gotta roll with it. That's what it is. For me, especially. Sometimes you just forget and it just like falls out.
What's something no one admits about being a musician?
Being a musician is having a cohesiveness with multiple ideas, players, and instruments all creating the same vision. And I think that's lost in translation sometimes, but it takes everybody like focusing on the one goal. So that takes a lot of work and effort, which is why we had villages, now we have cities, but music is kind of a root. You know, if you can get together with a whole bunch of people, no egos, like, what's the vision? Let's create it. I think that's the most awesome thing about music.
Name and band.
iVibes. Jay iVibes, but we're all out here doing the same thing regardless of the band name, the person's name. It's a collective energy. We're just trying to uplift our brothers and sisters. Always.
What's something no one admits about being a musician?
I would say the loading in and loading out process is a grind every single time, no matter where you are. Such as, for example, today, we had to get in an elevator that's barely big enough for two of us, and we got four guys loading in a truckload of gear. Must have taken us about an hour or so to get everything in here. Not the most fun process, but we do it because we love it. And
so I'm Smokey Lynn. So this is kind of a tough question, but
I would say that the humility is like when people feel your music or like you inspire some type of emotion, man, it just really, I don't know, it's almost like a drug that you get so stoked. Just, I don't know, you're looking out and sometimes you can see tears, sometimes you can see smiles, you see laughter and people being just so pumped or jumping around dancing to your music, and it's stuff that you wrote, just I don't know, it's just absolutely astounds me every single time. That's pretty much that's all I can really think of. So.
What's something no one admits about being a musician?
So nobody talks about the gigs where you play for nobody. It's disheartening, but you have to play as if you're at the sold out Coliseum, and give even a three person crowd the same performance as a 3,000 person crowd. And that's what nobody tells you. That's what nobody told me. And it just takes trial and error to get used to it.
Peace, love. The question is, that's the question? Okay, well here's the answer, here's the answer. Are we rolling, we're recording, we're good?
Yes, no, maybe so.
The 199th musician. Hello, here I am, K-Bong. Out of 200. And I'm glad I was a part of this. And the answer to your question is... That's it, all right, have a good night.
No, come back. I'm gonna include that in there.
Okay.
This is so cool. All right.
Hello.
Take two. What's something?
Oh, snap. Okay, sorry.
Take three. What's something no one admits about being a musician?
What's something nobody admits about being a musician? Wow. Nobody admits about being a musician. This is a good question. Hold on. Give me a edit. Oh, here we go. All right. Something that nobody admits about being a musician is maybe that it's a continuous journey. You're gonna keep learning, you're gonna keep growing as a musician, because there's always this idea of like, what's up, man, how's it going? There's always this idea of that we've made it, we're gonna make it, like I made it. When do you make it? I don't think there's a time where you make it. I think that it's a continuous learning, growing curve as a musician.
Oh. That musicians don't admit about being a musician, or that the audience doesn't?
Generally.
Most people don't admit all of the many hours that you spend not doing the very special magic of the show. There's like all the work that comes for 10 hours before and 5 hours after. It's harder than it looks, so. The rock star is a very short part of the job. The labor is a lot longer.
What's something no one tells you about being a musician?
That you should stretch before you do anything, always. Because that's the way to really truly rock out and not end up on an ice peg.
Something that no one admits about being a musician, that we're all just in it for the attention, that, you know, no matter whether you're a good musician or not, the being on stage and, you know, vibing out to a big crowd, that has appeal in and of itself. Most musicians will tell you more about the music, but it's not all about the music. We like people to appreciate our music. We like when people tell us, that was a great show, or that's an awesome song. Just like anybody else would, you know, when they do hard work and they put hard work into something, when people actually appreciate it, we really like it. So it's the nicest way I could say that we like attention.
How hard the work is.
Workload.
Hey, little brother.
Yeah.
What is the one thing nobody admits about being a musician?
Ooh. How hard it is.
a lot more work than it looks like.
It's not as much weed as you might think.
The farts in the van. You gotta deal with them. It's a thing. You're not a real musician unless you can deal with it.
I think something that no one admits is how hard it is on like your personal relationships with other people sometimes. Sometimes you have to give up having plans with friends and doing other things to sacrifice playing music. Everyone thinks it's all fun playing music late at night, and honestly a lot of times, like, you know, you wish you were out there dancing and having a good time yourself, so.
Jugs of water can go a long way on the road.
What's something no one admits about being a musician?
We're all on food stamps.
It's about 95% hard work, 5% fun.
What's something no one admits about being a musician?
Bed bugs.
Iranian and Swiss.
What's something no one admits about being a musician?
About touring? Let's see. That you can't poop on the bus.
Good one.
Solid.
Let's do it.
What's something no one admits about being a musician?
That sometimes you want to punch people in the... No, I'm just kidding. There's everything is very transparent, and we're all peaceful, loving people 24/7 all the time.
I'm about to kick.
No, I'm just kidding. So something that sucks about being a musician, you really want to go there? Something that sucks? Why can't we focus on all the good shit?
I said something that no one admits about.
Oh, something that no, okay, I'm sorry. See, like, see, law of attraction. See what I'm thinking? Something that no one admits about being a musician is that, god damn. I don't know if I want to go there. What kind of movie is this? What were you saying though? I'm sorry. Okay. All right. So something challenging about being a musician, I would say, honestly, I'm gonna look right here. Honestly, like, I guess for bands that don't have tour managers or people in charge, it's very, very hard to coordinate and get 8 people all on the same page. So the thing that I would admit, I'm gonna put these back on, I'm sorry. The thing that I would admit about being a musician is that it takes everything that you have, and you really, really have to just have a no matter what, till death mentality, and there's no half-assing anything, and you really have to give it your all. I mean, you know, people say that. I hear a lot of people say that, but like, to truly sacrifice everything, that's probably the hardest part, is to sacrifice relationships, your free time, anything that you want to do, anything, any relaxation, any free time, any vacations, sacrificing all of that just to go for it. That's probably the only thing that, not sucks, but the thing that you and have a lot of musicians don't, I guess, openly admit, is if that's a good enough answer.
What's something no one tells you about being a musician?
Oh, is that the question?
Yeah.
What's the question again?
What's something no one admits about being a musician? Yeah, I know. I'm grabbing
the rest of my money. They really can't play.
Roadies end up being a lot more important than groupies.
Oh man. I guess I would say that they don't tell you that sometimes it feels like in order to live the dream and do it as a career, it's sometimes like it's so little about the art itself. And sometimes I have to remind myself, like, okay, like, sit down, let's write a song. This is what brought you to this point. You know, this is what made you want to do this. So I would guess that's probably the biggest thing.
Something that no one admits about being a musician is that you need to wear flip-flops when you take showers in the green room. And that's a real thing. So, or even when you're at a hotel or if you're at a truck stop, you should always wear flip-flops when you use the shower after the show, whether that be in your green room or in your RV or your bus, whatever it is that you're taking a shower in, wear your flip-flops, kids.
That it's very, very stressful. Well, I guess people do admit that. Maybe they don't admit how stressful it really is. A lot of people talk about the sacrifice and
stress on the road and what it takes to sound good and, you know, connect with everybody. But there is a lot more underlying stress than I think people realize, and I think most musicians keep it together pretty well, mental health wise, and a lot of people don't see what it takes to really keep it together. I think that's something that a lot of people don't admit. I wish more people would admit, because it really does help us all when we do talk about it a little bit more, I think. Yeah.
You don't really make any money. All the money goes back into the machine and making it work. And you can't do it for money or else you're not going to be happy. That's just the deal. It ain't about the money. It's about everything else. And touring is also like playing the show is like 20 to 90 minutes of the job each time. And being on tour is so much more than that. And that's what tour is. It's not just a quick 30-minute show. That's just the fun part. The rest of it is not very easy. But
you gotta just do it.
And that's the deal.
You know what? I would say sometimes you're playing music and sometimes you feel that you may not be all there at times. Sometimes you don't feel able to play music. Sometimes you may be going through something that you're actually singing a song that you wrote, that you're trying to speak a message, that you're also going through it. So an example is one of our songs is called Round and Around. And it speaks about a message where people go through problems in life and how it's about don't giving up. And I think everyone can kind of relate to that song because in some kind of way we all go through our seasons, right? Good seasons, bad seasons, seasons change. But sometimes some of those seasons are difficult. And sometimes if we're going through any problems in life, whether it be work, whether it be school, whether it be family, you know, we're singing that song, trying to speak that message, but we're hurting inside too. So I think something like that, like I can admit as a musician, when we play certain songs that has a meaning that we're trying to encourage others, we're actually struggling with singing it as well with you and trying to get that message for ourselves.
All right, when you're ready, what's something no one admits about being a musician?
Groupies really ain't that hot.
So one thing that I don't really like to admit about being a musician, but it's true, it's all the way true, is I have made 17,041 beer tickets in my life, and I've probably made about 32 fucking actual US dollars.
The extreme highs and lows of being on the road and just all the little finer things. Everyone thinks that just because you're on stage it's just a glamorous life, but there's a lot of struggle, lots of paying your dues, and in the end it's very rewarding, but there's definitely lots of highs and lows.
Partying 5 nights out of the week gets old quick.
Some of us don't have, aren't truly as confident as people believe that we are. Like, for me, I have to like lie to myself, you know. But, you know, I feel confident, but when I'm on stage, it's like I kind of black out and it's a different kind of confidence that I don't truly have in my personal life. But, you know, it's all a work in progress and we'll get there.
We make most of our money off of merch.
We all talk about the hard work we put in, but probably the sacrifice the most. Missing out on friends and family's birthdays, just weddings. I just missed one of my best friend's weddings. The little things like that, you know, you don't really think about it that much, but then when you're on the road, it really hits hard. So friends and family's the best thing we miss out on for sure.
Basically that you go home right after the show and don't get the girls and pretty much are kind of a nerd when it comes to it. It's just about the music and it's not about the glamour or whatever else.
Sometimes you're on a show and people are like, oh, you guys did awesome, killed it. And we're like, oh man, we've sucked tonight. Can't believe that people like that. But that's not tonight though. That's the other nights though, when you see that.
It's hard as hell, really. It's really hard. You gotta do a lot of work for free. You gotta move heavy equipment. And you gotta deal with bar owners if you're like playing covers for money or whatever. You gotta deal with bar owners, and you know, you gotta deal with finding gigs, you know, And so it's a lot of work that goes into it that people don't realize. And then also if you're writing originals, you have to dedicate time to that. And it's a hard balance sometimes because you got to survive too. So, musicians don't have it very easy because a lot of them have to work and then they have to take the extra time after working to write or to play or practice or whatever. So, give musicians some tips when you see them. When we're out here working really hard, what you see is just like the cherry on the top of the cake that took hours to bake and decorate. Yeah.
What's something no one admits about being a musician?
That they don't practice enough.
That it's not for everybody. It's definitely for those people that are driven to communicate with people through music, through their art, and it's, you go through a lot when you're creating, and then when you're trying to express these on stage and in the studio, it takes a lot out of a person to be that vulnerable. So I don't think a lot of people understand that there's a vulnerability to it at the same time of, there's a vulnerability at the same time as being able to go on stage and, cast yourself as like this big guy, like, oh yeah, feelings don't matter, but they really do. So you have to be vulnerable when you're a musician, you're an artist.
I don't know if we don't admit it. I think we all admit it, but it's not known that there's like a lot of struggles that go on behind the scenes to make it all happen.
Nobody admits. Honestly, for me, you're in a band, it's a team, it's a crew, and people think it's just all fun all the time and stuff like that, but it's almost like when I was on a football team in high school, you gotta get serious, you gotta lock down, you have to work together. Like, even if one person is slacking, it affects the entire group. So like, which one that's going good, that's where the fun happens. But there is, you gotta grind and you gotta stay focused when you're tired or whatever. But that's why I love playing with Tidal Theory, because we're all like that. It's like a true team, and that's why we call them a family. So.
No one admits it's a struggle, and I mean that in the sense of relationships in particular. It's a grind. It's always a grind. But if you start being a pro musician and you're already in a relationship, it can be very hard to get your partner on board with the hours and the amount of effort that goes into it. If you are already a musician and you start a new relationship, it might be a little bit easier. I don't have that experience, but I will say, as a married person that's been married for 4 years and I started this a year ago, it's a constant battle. My wife supports my music ventures, but the late hours, the weekends, you're taking up all of the free time that you would have with your partner if you're on the same schedule specifically. And it can be very taxing, and you need to be on the same page. And there's a lot of concessions to be made on both sides. That is the one thing I will say.
To me, it doesn't just flow. It doesn't always flow. It's hard work to try to get to that point where you're feeling that freedom in the writing and the singing. It is not like you wake up every day and you're going, oh, I'm just ready to, be a beacon for all those people out there who we carry the same message and feel the same way in human nature. It's really a grind, especially trying to get your feelings and emotions out. So a lot of people will be like, it's hard, man. It's hard to write a song. It's hard to write your 10th song. It's hard to write your 30th song, your 50th song, and it gets harder to me. It doesn't get any easier. So maybe a lot of people won't admit that because they want to seem cool, like they got it, and that they it all flows. But that's a little bit of bullshit to me. It doesn't flow to me. But it comes out eventually, but you have to kind of sift through it,
One thing I don't want to miss is like, I'm pretty much a wide open book about everything, love to talk about everything, but sometimes like I've been caught with my fly down, and you know, like, I get embarrassed about that. I'm like, oh shit, I gotta zip this up. And then, but you know, I'll be like, nobody really noticed, right? Like, you know, but yeah, I don't like to admit that. That's the only thing.
Something that no one admits. You know what, I never really tell this, but for me, what it means to me is that music is life. Music is power. Music is the remedy. It is the remedy of everything for me, and I'm sure a lot of musicians. It gives life. That's what music is all about.
Oh, okay. So like, say you're playing a gig and you got a gig that day, right? Your whole day is based around that gig, right? Like, just not playing from 6 to 9 p.m. is the gig, but driving 3 hours to the gig is the gig, and then figuring out all that stuff, like, the gig is the whole life. Like, there isn't just, it never stops kind of thing when you're, I don't know, when you're always gigging and stuff. Yeah.
I would say that we're probably a little bit more critical of ourselves than you might think. Despite, like, hearing everyone say, oh, like, great job, great show, you played great. I feel like a lot of us are often leaving shows feeling like, thinking about all the things we could have done better. So I think a lot of being a musician is kind of overcoming those like self-doubts and like second-guessing ourselves and just being happy with everything we put out because people enjoy it.
I would say it's a lot of hard work and dedication. You know, you got to put in your 10,000 hours just to be good at whatever you do, whether that's the booking side of things, the running a business in terms of the band, getting really good at your craft, like your instrument. And then on top of that, just like learning about like the logistical side of things, like purchasing, like dealing with like not being on a tour bus for maybe the first 10 years of your career and just being in a van for a while, crashing at finding people to stay at your house or whatever. Yeah.
Something people don't admit about music is really what it takes, as we're a quad, so we have four people in our band. Donis on guitar, Rodney on keys, Casey on drums, I'm on bass. Really, it's about having a synchronicity and a cadence, and this is almost like if you've ever been in a relationship with, you know, just one other person, how difficult that can be. You can imagine that four grown adult men trying to get along and being cohesive. That's probably the hardest part. And all the jumble I just said, in conclusion, being cohesive and understanding your bandmates. That's the hardest part. It's hard to have a cohesiveness with a new band member or a new band in general. It's often like being onboarded to a new job, a new 9-to-5 if you've ever had one. At first you're timid, you're not yourself, you're not really speaking, you know, your mind. And that, that leads to you not being truthful. Whereas in Guavatron, I've known my drummer since he was 5 years old, who grew up on the same street. I met my guitarist in middle school. I met my keyboardist in middle school. And I think what really keeps us together is that I could be like, one day I could be like, fuck you. And the next day I could be like, I love you. And that's it. And you can't do that with other bands because of the lack of relationship. So it all comes from the heart, and it all comes from a bonding, and it ends with a cohesive and clear thesis. And that's that.
What's something no one admits about being a musician?
What's something no one admits? I think everyone's afraid of success. To every good point, do it, you know. But eventually, they conquer their fears, and then life becomes success as it is.
Do not delay me, bro.
Okay, I'm
ready.
Fucking bass
player. Let's go.
Rock, paper, scissors, shoot.
No!
Was that a rock or a scissor? I'll go first, fuck it. Oh, what an asshole. Nah, that's scissors.
What's something no one admits about being a musician?
Personal hygiene. The amount of time that goes into being on the road and spending like the time away from your family. It's always like fun, grass is always green on the other side, but it really is a lot. And, yeah, that's one thing that I don't talk about a lot. That and how much fucking fun we have. Yeah.
Oh shit, you're gonna throw me off guard here? Looking right at my grill? Alright, what do we got?
What's something no one admits about being a musician?
Oh, that it fucking sucks sometimes. That's what I'll say. Touring isn't always fun, but it is. Pros, cons. So, there you go. I'll keep it short.
One thing no one admits about being a musician. How smelly the tour bus is.
Something no one admits about being a musician? Fuck, probably like the truth, just the truth in general, you know?
All right, something that musicians don't admit is when they play in a cover band because they don't believe in themselves to play originals.
Game!
Ooh!
Ooh!
I tell the truth!
Well, self-doubt is a bitch. But no matter how far you go or who you are, you're always gonna somehow, those negative thoughts come into your brain. So fuck that and do you, boo.
Yes!
Woo! Yes!
That's a good one.
Do you, boo!
That, oh, that there is no real way to make it. I learned from my experience with TikTok and music and all that, that it's just hard work. You know, everybody looks to somebody, to these celebrities or musicians or whatever, they want to know the secret to making it. And the secret is becoming the best at who you are and the best at what you do. Because there's nobody that can do what you do. It's just like me. There's nobody that does what I do. Even if I sound like somebody else, nobody's doing it the way I do or engineers it the way I do. So you just got to become the best at what you do. And you have to be humble enough to learn things and understand that you are a long ways away from where you could be. Even if it's, you know, even if where you are right now is comfortable, but there's no secret to making it. It's hard work, and that's one thing that I don't think anybody ever told me.
Basically, my biggest thing that nobody told me about was living in a van down by the river.
Ooh, what's one thing that nobody missed about being a musician? Is that it's okay to suck sometimes. All right, sometimes you'll miss that note and you'll panic. Don't panic, just get right back in the flow and just finish your set, all right?
I've always had this problem where I'm always in my head when I'm playing, so I'm always questioning if I'm playing the song right, like live. But I always do. No one admits. I mean, it's a lot of fun. It gets very hot on stage. I don't feel like people talk about that. It's just a lot of fun. I don't know. I don't know that people would need to admit that. I think people do talk about that.
It could be
this is what it is.
It could be
talent doesn't make the musician, I don't think. But creativity does. That's what it is. It's more about how creative you are, less about how technically skilled you are. Obviously, that technical skill can help you with your doing more creative things, but I think that you can be really bad at whatever instrument you're playing and still get a really good response from it. If you have a lot of stage presence and personality and creativity. I think that's I think what it is. That sometimes it's not fun. It's a lot of work if you want to take it seriously. And I don't think any musicians will admit that. A lot of them just kind of be like, yeah, we're just in it to have fun. But a lot of times it's a lot of hard work. But if you love it enough, it just kind of all comes out in the wash.
Probably the amount of work it actually takes. Like, a lot of people think that it just kind of happens and you're just kind of given a gift. but it actually takes a whole lot of work. A lot of people won't say it. I mean, a lot of musicians are humble that way. Not all of them, obviously, but a lot of people, yeah, won't go into detail about how much work actually goes into getting to where they are. You know, that's the first thing to come to mind.
That most people suck, bro. You gotta be good to make it, okay? Sorry. I suck too, so I'm not making it either, but that's it.
A lot of it's really boring. A lot of it's standing around, waiting for shit to happen. Yeah, a lot of waiting.
I think people think musicians get friends, get laid, get whatever. It doesn't get you any of that automatically. It just gets you in front of people. And then whoever you are shines through or doesn't shine through. You know, there's musicians who have tons of friends, tons of popularity. There's musicians who kind of do their own thing and don't bask in the spotlight. And it's all, the whole spectrum. So maybe that's...
Yeah. We're all nuts. We're absolutely insane. Out of our minds. That's it.
One thing that no one admits to being a musician is that it's a lot of work. A lot of work.
Try to get my sweat off my brow.
What's one thing no one admits about being a musician?
No one admits about being a musician is you get off stage and you're really sweaty and people want to talk to you and you look like crap. That's one thing. What was the question again? I'll rephrase it.
What's something no one admits about being a musician?
What's something nobody admits about being a musician? That it's fun all of the time.
I would say, you know, people like to glamorize life being on the road and touring and stuff like that, but there's a darker side to it that takes a toll on people's mental state and stuff, being gone away from family for so long. You know, it could be loved ones, it could be pets, it could be parents, girlfriends, whatever. But you know, a lot of people look at it and they think it's like, you know, you're going out, you're partying, you're having fun, but it's a lot of work. And it takes a lot out of you, especially, like I said, when you're leaving loved ones behind and stuff, and you're on the road so long, you don't really have any sense of stability a lot of time because you're from one town to another town to another town. It's different places, it's different people, so it's, yeah. I mean, a lot of, like, that's probably it. You know, it's the whole touring thing is, it's great. I love it. It's, you know, it's what we dream about, what we love doing, but it's a lot harder than I think what some people give it credit for.
The grind.
It's a documentary. It's asking you a question about musicians.
Okay, cool. I asked you about you because they don't want it.
Just lay it on me. Go ahead.
What's something no one admits about being a musician?
Hold on, let me get that. Honestly, what's something... Something that nobody admits, that most musicians deal with, is the fact that none of this shit actually keeps any of them going. Very rarely are they actually keeping going from being a musician, but everyone talks about being a full-time musician, but most of the time, either they're broke as fuck and they are, or they're full of shit. It's a tough road.
Bax. Music sucks! Quit now!
That's a good question. It's hard. It's very hard. A lot of sleepless nights. A lot of playing for nobody. A lot of blood, sweat, and tears. A lot of being away from home.
Rock on, ain't no walk in the park.
Oh, he's hitting
the field. That's absolutely right. And, you know, if it was easy, wouldn't we all... We'd all be a rock star.
That's right.
So just keep on pushing forward, all you musicians out there. That's all I got.
I feel like we all admit this one thing, but we don't talk about it enough, and it's practice. It's a lot of practice, you know? In order for you to become successful at your craft, you have to really spend time with it. You have to sit down with it. You have to eat, breathe, drink it. It has to be an everyday part of your life if you really intend to take it to the next level. So I think that's one thing that we admit, but it's somewhat overlooked, you know? Yeah.
What's something no one admits about being a musician?
Oh, that their bandmates all smell like turtles. All of them. Hold on. Give me 1 minute. I can never find my shoes. I can't find my shit.
What's something no one admits about being a musician?
Running out of weed, because that shit sucks.
It's probably how last minute some things are and how unplanned some things can be. How something can be just like, you know, dropped on you and, hey, are you ready to do it? And you just automatically have to be ready, kind of thing. It's probably the most thing, yeah.
I would say maybe the awkward looks, you making eye contact, you know, trying to play it cool and like look like you're cool up there, but really you don't know how you look. And then maybe I say one of the harder things is probably just how many friends you meet and how many friends, you know, come and go. You know, just so many people, so many beautiful memories, and sometimes they don't last long enough.
That some of us are nervous wrecks and that playing music is a coping mechanism. And you wouldn't even be able to tell that sometimes we're losing our shit, even when we're putting out beautiful music and the vibes.
All right, what is one thing nobody admits about being a musician?
Playing music is great, but all the work you have to do around that period of time where you get to play music sucks. It's load in 3 hours before you play for an hour, tear it all down. A 1 hour show is 6 hours, and by the time you split the pay up five ways and figure you've just worked 7 hours, maybe you should have just stayed home. But playing the music, it's like a little, you know what I mean? It's the pleasure center, the reward center of your brain. So that's what I got.
And what's your name and band?
Jay from Victims of Circumstance.
Awesome, thank you.
I think something that no one admits being a musician is all the waiting around time that you have. You know, you show up to a gig and there's probably like a couple hours that you're wasting where you can actually do something positive with your music. So bring something to record with, any writing pad, if something influenced you at the show, write it down. But yeah, a lot of wasted time nobody tells you about.
And they get nervous every time they go on stage.
Oh, that's such a good one. Okay, so we do this out of our hearts. We play music because it fulfills our souls, right? But deep down inside, there's this longing for connection, right? We want to connect with other people. We do this so that we can feel close or sharing experiences with other people, and we can all grow that way. So one thing that you might not know is that when we're up there and we're giving ourselves that sense of connection, that sense of, you know, reaching out to pull away positive vibes and in turn provide them for people, it makes us feel like superheroes. The exact moment where we get a reaction out of the fans, the exact moment where you can tell someone's sharing the same experiences or feeling what you're feeling in the moment, or in that one moment they've connected with your song, that makes us feel like superheroes.
All right, I'm ready.
What is one thing nobody admits about being a musician?
One thing that nobody admits about being a musician. All right. So everyone thinks it's really cool, but like a lot of it is practice and working hard, and like the reason why people think that musicians are really cool is because like that's something that really they're really into. Like, you know, like you can find anyone that's into something really cool and you think they're cool about it. Like, you know, you can find someone who's like really into like, you know, building things and stuff. Like, they think that's really awesome. But like, you know, musicians are a different breed in the same sense of like, you know, they're really into like doing music. So like one thing that a lot of people don't know about musicians and all that stuff is like we're literally just the same type of people in that sense. Like, we're just trying hard to like make things work and like working at it and like putting the effort, and like the product that people see is essentially like the final product in that sense. And, you know, and so like I've always been like telling folks that like, you know, the more effort you put into it, the more you get out of it. So that is essentially where I am.
You actually have to spend before you make it. I've been broke.
When you're not playing shows and everyone else is, you feel left behind.
some people don't listen to any of the other bands in their genre.
That you constantly compare your success to other musicians' success.
That you compare yourself to literally every other musician that you see play.
What's something no one admits about being a musician? That they listen to their own shit.
Oh, how people talk shit behind your back every time they get a chance to.
I guess that we're vulnerable a little bit, you know. Music is a way for all of us to kind of connect in our own ways, you know, personally. And we find that peace within music. And to get out here and create it, and do what you love, and try to serve it the best way, it can be a little scary. So you're out here and you're your real self when you're performing, so a little vulnerability.
Professional musician? Nobody told me how to make it work. Nobody told me how to make money out of it. Nobody told me how to make it a business. I had to learn that. As far as being a musician, nobody told me how self-critical I was gonna have to be. That was my answer.
You're in trouble.
How many guitar picks you go through? You go through a million of them. You know, I lose three at least. And strings. I break strings almost every show.
Well, something that no one admits about being a musician. And no matter what anybody says, you always have like a little nervousness when you get in front of a crowd, you know what I mean? But, you know, even if this would last like 2 seconds or like 2 minutes or whatever, no matter what, as many years as I've been in front of a crowd, I always get just like a little bit, you know, but a good nervousness, you know what I mean? But yeah, I don't care what nobody says, it always happens, you know? So,
one thing. What is one thing nobody admits about being a musician?
It generally sucks. No one really likes your music and you don't have any real fans.
Perfect. And what's your name and band?
I'm Lindsay and I'm in Victims of Circumstance.
Awesome. Thank you.
Something no one admits about being a musician is really how spiritual this is. I mean, even if you're not making spiritual music, you're still creating frequencies. You're still creating content that is impacting people's lives. And so this is a spiritual journey. And music is what connects all things in creation. So I think people don't, you know, like to admit that or really don't like to give it that type of credit, but it's definitely there. You can't deny it. You can't deny it one bit. So definitely.
Question is, what is something no one admits about being a musician? And my answer is something that's been very present for me the last few months. So the timing of this question's serendipitous. I get a platform to share this. Touring sucks, really. It's an amazing thing that we get to share our music with the world, new venues, new people. Connecting with people is the greatest thing. This is why we do this. It's why we play music. But the way that we tour, generally as musicians, especially as we start to grow, is we spend more and more time on the road. Being on the road for a month, 2 months, 3 months is grueling, it's taxing physically, emotionally, and mentally. And no one really tells you that getting into it. It puts a huge strain on home life. If you have a home life, if you have a family, if you have kids, if you are trying to have a family and start a family and have kids, puts a lot of stress on that, the ability to cultivate that. I guess I want to say my solution to all this too. I think that we shouldn't be touring as musicians for 2-3 months straight. I think that what we should do is tour for 1 week and then 3 weeks off. 1 week on, 3 weeks off, maybe 2 weeks tops. I want to be there. I want to have a family. I want to have a family and I want to be able to play music. It's what I do. It's my calling in life as much as having a family is. So having the two things be compatible is something I've been meditating on every day, especially as I get more and more into being a musician and playing music and touring.
That
not everybody's gonna like your music. No matter how many hours, years you spend playing, practicing, writing a song, and you might think it's this beautiful thing that you've created, someone out there might not like it. But I don't let that get to me, because music can truly save somebody, and it saved my life. And I think music is one of the best gifts you can give to somebody.
Their weaknesses. Nobody ever admits their weaknesses. Everybody always wants to flex on what they have over somebody instead of just looking up at somebody who does something that they do better than they do and just going, damn, that's a bad motherfucker. And that's the thing, is that you want to surround yourself with people like that, because steel sharpens steel. You know, surround yourself with bad motherfuckers. If you're the baddest motherfucker in the room, you're in the wrong fucking room. So yeah, their weaknesses, their shortcomings. Be like, hey man, you have something that's really fucking good that I can't do. Can you show me how to do that? Just put your ego aside, just to be like, let me learn from you. Doesn't matter if I'm 20 years fucking older than you than not. Doesn't matter if I've been playing longer than you. If you've got something that I can pick up, fucking show me. Egos and fucking admitting your weaknesses is probably the one thing that most musicians will never admit to.
Perfect. And what's your name and band?
My name is Billy Bones. I play with the Bull Daughters out of Cocoa Beach, Florida.
Awesome. Thank you.
Oh, it's something nobody admits? I don't know. It's all pretty cool. No one admits being a musician. Sometimes you're not gonna love everybody that you're playing with, and you just have to deal with it and come back and circle around and make everybody happy. And, it's tough making everybody happy, I guess. But toughest thing being a musician, spending all your money on good gear. Because if you don't have good gear, you sound like crap. So you have guitars that cut out and nasty strings and all that, but I don't know. Next question.
Realistically, the chances of you being a very successful musician are slim to none.
Hey, my mom says I'm amazing.
You hear that? Exactly. See? Yeah. So
there's more.
I was gonna say something else, but yeah. That's the sad, unfortunate truth. Because you'll pour your heart into something that you love so dearly, and you sacrifice a lot, and you know, unfortunately, a lot of times it ends up in vain. Well, I see a lot of musicians struggle. But on the other side of the token, you know, one thing, the opposite of what you're not going to be told is what you will be told. You'll be told a lot of shit by a lot of people, and you'll be made a lot of promises. And I think at the end of the day, you have to do what you want to do as a musician, because there's, at the core of who you are as a musician is your art. And I think that's why you should be doing it. So, obviously not to make money, but if your goals and aspirations are to be successful, be number one, do it for another reason. That's what I got.
So, there's so much that goes behind the scenes with practicing, setting up for shows, tearing down, and sacrifice is something that you have to do to be a musician. So, like, having kids is trying to find that balance. And you have like this life here as a musician, and then you have like your own personal life. And the hardest thing that people don't think about or talk about is trying to find that balance. And it's so hard to be like a national act and tour and still have a family and have a good relationship with your spouse, with your children. So I think that's something that people hopefully think about before they become a musician, because that's something that's not talked about enough, and it's real, it's deep.
You don't make no money. You know, passion is what drives you. If you're in it for the money or you think you're gonna get big, you're not. But with the right work ethic and sacrifice, you can get there.
All right. What is one thing nobody says about being a musician?
I make too much money.
Maybe. It's the kind of thing, if you're really a musician and you're really passionate about it, sometimes you do it for nothing. Because sometimes someone might come to me and say, Sal, can you drop a vocal on this really good? Can you drop a keyboard on this? And it's not all the time that we talk to you about money. Sometimes we just want to get it done. And we'll talk to you about that later on. Or sometimes that person would do a favor for you later on. Make sense?
No one tells you that you also have to be a manager, a booking agent, a social media guy, an accountant, a small business owner. No one tells you that you have to do all this other shit. But, you know, you learn. So it all works out in the end. But hey, just so you know, there's a lot more to it these days, at least. So.
One thing nobody tells me about being a musician is the nights that you try to create something and your brain won't do it. And it's like everyone expects you to be like Johnny on the spot, tap dancing for him at any given second. And you sitting at home struggling to write a verse down or thinking, and you're like, what is going on here? You know, I don't know. That's what I thought of on the fly. There's a lot of different things you can tell someone, but that's my one thing just off the fly right now. Yeah.
Well, especially like with touring, no one tells you how like important like camaraderie is and being able to deal with each other. It's like being in a big relationship with like four people at the same time. It's kind of like, I don't know, it's a good time, but it's rough at times, you know what I'm saying? Everything smells like balls and it's hot and you're just traveling. And it's worth it though, you know, it's the grind, infinite grind. But yeah, no one ever tells you about that.
It's hard work. Practice every day. Enjoy music every day. Make it your life. Every second you wake up, make music your priority in your life and push as hard as you can to be the best you can every second of every day.
What's something that no one admits about being a musician?
It is hard and it is a lot of serious work. Like, it's actually a commitment and something that you have to put energy and discipline towards every single day. Like, it's not just fun and games, but it is fun and games after the hard work.
Good answer. Good.
It's really just as awesome as it looks.
One thing I would say not many musicians admit is, you know, this, the touring lifestyle can be very not glamorous. you can take a look around here and kind of see what I mean, or any given number of venues. But yeah, sometimes it's amazing, and the you know, the accommodations are great, but yeah, sometimes it's not, and you're just like loading in through alleys and doing what you can do with the space provided. But yeah,
gets really smelly in the bus, like really smelly. Like, bring your own bottle of Febreze. I'm telling you this, I'm a little embarrassed to tell you this, but I have to Febreze the hallway every day. It's so gross.
What's something that no one admits about being a musician?
Ooh. I guess it's kind of heavy because you're carrying out art into the world and you're bringing, you're drawing from spirit or drawing from wherever you draw inspiration from. Transmuting it into art, and sometimes it's kind of heavy, and it's kind of a big load, and a lot of people, I guess, wouldn't really think about that.
That it, you know, it's what that no one admits about being a musician. You know that it sucks to suck for a long time, and then you get really good, and then you get to do shit, and then you want to get better, and then the more you learn, the more you realize that you got to keep getting better, and more you learn, the more you realize you'll never get all those things. And then when you get a couple places, and then you start missing the shit out of your family because you have two daughters and your wife back home, but you're out here getting like renovated by like all the fans every single night. So those are a couple different things, I guess, that people don't tell you about being a musician.
She's doing her thing right now.
I would have to say, I think it would be the insecurity, like, coming up with an idea and kind of trashing it in your own head and like saying like, oh no, that's not gonna be good enough, or no, it's not like that. Maybe no one's gonna feel this one. Nobody's gonna like this one. And you know, then scrapping it and maybe like coming back to another idea and then like that constant fight of like, is this gonna be good enough? Is this gonna be? Is it? Does it work? You know what I mean? Does it work? Not only does it work for you, does it work for the people? Like, is it gonna land? Is it? You know, it's very every time we put something out, it's like a little piece of vulnerability, a little piece of yourself that you're putting out. And it gets critiqued by everybody, obviously, so sometimes it's really hard to get out of your own head, to get out of that little bit of fear, a little bit of insecurity of how's it going to go over, is it going to go over well, you know, that whole feeling. So I'd say a little bit of fear and insecurity that that artists have to deal with, most likely probably on a regular basis. That'd probably be it. Yeah. This is Kareem Israel of Arise Roots.
No one admits about being a musician. That being a female musician is kind of like a casting call, and no one wants to admit that. But it is. But if you're badass, it doesn't really matter. So just do it, you know, like, and be badass.
Be badass.
Yeah.
She's a badass.
What's your name? My name is Brittany. Brittany Mack.
Brittany Matter!
I'm the drummer for Surfer Girl. Play drums. And it's what I love. It's my passion.
Perfect. About being a musician is that it is 99.999% rejection. You will be rejected for shows. You will be rejected from other musicians, from other bands. And I don't think most people are really used to that or prepared for that. And then once you really start pushing in music, you have to really become accustomed to it and not let it faze you. You have to just learn to keep pushing through, you know, all the rejection that you experience. I think that kind of spills over into your personal life as well, where, you know, things start to bother you less. And then when you become rejected in maybe your personal life or your professional life, it starts to phase you a lot less because you're just more used to it. So I think that'd be my answer. So
name and band.
My name is Vincent and I play for the band Ichronic.
What's your role?
I'm the water boy. So I play bass.
What's something no one admits about being a musician?
We love being on the road most, being on stage most. I mean, we love our families, we love everything, we love home and all of that, but when you're on that stage, it's a whole different energy, a whole different vibe. That's where you feel alive. That's where you feel like yourself if you're a real musician. That's your happy place. So sometimes we don't really share that with people. You know what I mean? Everybody thinks it's all fun and games, it's on a vacation or whatever because you're traveling. But no, this is our headspace. You know what I mean? And we love it. We wouldn't trade it for anything else. Sorry to say, but that's what we do. That's what we love to do. If you're real,
it's a lot of hard work. It takes a lot of perseverance and dedication. There's many times when you like think you're not gonna make it, but you have the love in your heart, you know, and you gotta keep going. And that's really hard. It's really hard. Like, it can like hurt your soul almost sometimes. But the music provides that love and it just sustains you, keeps you going. So perseverance and you gotta keep going. You gotta keep trying. That is like one of the, I feel like that's the one thing that that gets a lot of people, you know, to stop, is because it's just, it's so hard. It's so hard to keep going, you know. But for everyone out there, if you're got a love for music in your heart and you're feeling it and you want to give something to the world, keep at it, keep going. I played the sandwich shop, Potbelly, and I can't tell you how many times like people would come up to me and they go, yo, keep going, please keep going. And it's it meant a lot to me for them to say that. And so I don't know, for anyone out there, keep going.
That we're tired all of the time.
We get very, very little sleep. Traveling from town to town, we're always on a really tight schedule. I think people tend to think that we're living this like super freedom-centric existence, and that is not the case at all. We're completely dictated by a schedule at all times, and most of the time that means we don't sleep.
So when I started thinking about going full-time with music, I approached my friends and family and stuff like that, and I was confronted with a lot of, you can't make it, nobody makes it in the music industry, and you need a real job and stuff like that. And what they don't tell you is it is a real job, and it's great, and I have the best job ever, and I've been doing it now for 12 years full-time, and I'm very appreciative, and I hope it continues for the rest of my working life. And the cool thing is, you don't need the music industry anymore to be successful in the music business.
That being on the road, once you leave your family, you miss them a lot. And it's the hardest thing to do. You don't think about it when you start, but when you leave for months on end, the family is the only thing you think about. So no one really expects it, but the hardest part and the gnarliest is family and leaving them. So no one admits it. It's all fun and games, but you get homesick big time. Big time homesick. So that's it.
This is a hard question, I'm not gonna lie. I guess the one thing that people don't admit is that maybe we're from another place other than Earth. Maybe, I don't know, that's just freestyle, but but music is the universal language. I'll leave it at that. Bless. Peace!
Something that nobody admits that happens to me is that when I'm on stage, I feel less nervous than when I'm not, because I have a lot of friends, and the guest list is crazy, and taking care of all my friends is crazy, but I love them so much. So what I'm admitting is that it's the opposite. When I'm on stage, no cell phone, you can't talk to me, you can't ask me where this is, if you can get another friend on the list, being on stage is my peaceful zone, it's almost like, so I'm sleep mode.
My name is Marley D. Williams, and I'm in the band Revolution.
I guess it's that we have the best job in the world, but we don't want to admit that. Thanks to everybody out there, that's for sure.
Everybody's cooler when they're dead. And nobody cares until everybody cares. What I mean is, this is not for the weak-hearted, and you have to be okay with people not believing in you. You have to be okay with being a nobody. You have to be okay with failure. You have to be okay with not succeeding. And you have to not be okay with not succeeding, because once you not succeed, you have to pick yourself up, like Aaliyah said, and just dust yourself off and try again. And everyone blows up after they die. It's interesting. You know, some of your idols aren't going to be nice. You also can live your dream. If you speak it out to the world and you have faith in yourself and the divine mystic law of cause and effect, you put out love, you put out good energy, and good energy and love is going to come back. And that's all that matters, is love. The key ingredient to good art, to me, is love. Love can turn to hate quickly. There's a dark side in art as well. I choose to spread the light and the love as much as I can, while realizing I'm not perfect and I have infinite work to do, and I could always grow more. And I hope everyone likes me before I die. It'd be great. And I'm just happy to be here, and I'm so thankful that my creator has blessed me with some of my wildest dreams, and it's all because I believed in myself and I believed in that energy. I challenged that energy, thank you, to be real. Talk to the sky and tell him, show yourself to me, and I'll believe in you. And I'm willing to bet that if you keep asking, you will get the answer that your heart desires. My name is Pure Powers. and I'm here to spread aloha. God bless you guys. Chase your dreams at all cost. And I want to tell you that you can do anything your heart desires as long as you give it your all and you pray really hard. That's what that worked for me. I truly believe it'll work for you as well. So thanks for being here, and I'm honored to answer the questions. I'm out here with my idols, Crouch and Slug, and Atmosphere, and Iration, and Pacifier. Everyone's been so cool, and I just want to keep shining love and light. So thank you, Cocoa Peach. Thank you, One Question. And shouts out to the 199 other artists. I love y'all.
What's something no one admits about being a musician?
How often I see my bandmate naked. How sweaty you will be all the time. But it's pretty great.
They don't admit? Well, I guess how lonely it is. I guess you wouldn't really think that it's lonely, but because you're around so many people. But we miss our families, we miss our loved ones, so I think that's probably something that most people forget about. I wouldn't say that many musicians wouldn't admit it, but that's something that I think that most people don't really think about very much, so that's my answer.
I think one thing about being a traveling musician that people don't admit is how taxing and how hard it can be physically and mentally. A lot of times you kind of only just see the show aspect, whereas one of the hardest things about being a musician is the travel and just the constant motion every day. It's something we all love, but it's definitely something that's hard to admit.
Something that no one admits about being a musician is that they're scared what the public is going to think of them.
That's an interesting question. I think that musicians typically don't admit the amount, how do I say, I don't even know how to put this into words.
I can pause it if you'd like.
No, that's fine. You can just edit it if you'd like to. That way I'm just kind of, but I think that we pour so much into everything that we do, and it takes so much out of us. But then when we perform and when we write the music, it's almost like it gives us life again. So I think that we always admit how much we love what we do, but there's also this like draining side of it of giving so much to the audience and so much to the listener that you almost forget about that, because right away you're replenished with that energy once again. Do you know what I mean? Does that make any sense? I don't know how to say it. I wish I was better with words. That's about it.
Actually, I think not a lot of musicians might tell you, if you're just getting started, that no one in their right fucking mind would do this. You gotta be a little crazy if you want to do music. Musicians are the most conceited people on planet Earth. There's nothing they won't admit. Especially with a camera in their face. Musicians love talking about themselves. Try to find something they won't talk about.
And what's your name and
where my name is Jacob you? Noel from Jacob's Castle, and we will reign for 1,000 years.
I would say the best advice, not necessarily advice, but maybe something that a lot of us don't admit, is with your dreams, you have to understand that you can achieve all your dreams. It might just not be exactly how you dreamed it. Few of us are doing exactly how we dreamed it, you know what I mean?
So one thing that musicians all around the world that don't ever say about anything about being a musician is that we're broke, and we do it for the fucking love of it, and we don't care, because this is our drive and passion, and we do it for you guys, and if money comes, it comes. If it doesn't, we're still gonna do it, because this is our life, and we love doing it.
Well, one of the biggest things is repetition. You know, it takes a million tries before you become an expert at something, and that's certainly true with being a musician. You know, it's a whole lot of doing something over and over, nailing down every single, you know, little mistake, and eventually you come out with the perfect result. So it's, you know, real satisfying when that happens. Just a great, great career hobby for anybody. Highly recommend it.
So something that nobody admits about being a musician, I would have to say that feeling that you get when you finally release a song. You know, people are listening to that, people are inspired by that, people are, you know, making your music a part of their life. And there's no better feeling than, you know, knowing that somebody else is, you know, enjoying your music out there. That's the part nobody tells you about.
I think that, you know, people don't really know or say how much of the grind that is in that. You know, it's like, I forgot what I was saying. It's like 10% grind, or 10% music and 90% grind. Like, you're grinding, you know. People think you're out there partying this and that, but when you're on a bus tour and you're the opener and you don't have a bus or a person driving, and then you gotta play your gig and then go drive to the next city, like, that's an example of, like, not, you know, music being 10% of it and then the 90% grind to even get there. And that's what I think nobody talks about, I guess.
I guess it can be kind of hard on your personal life, like just the variance of the amount of things you do and the amount of places you go make it kind of hard to have just a normal family life and like just a regular sort of life in general that fits with friends, partners, everybody. It's probably that.
Yeah, something no one admits about being a musician is that often we have another job. Or like if you're a musician that has another job, often you don't admit that to other musicians because there's something about like artistry and like, you know, being dedicating yourself to art and like that being like a true thing that you don't want to like also have like a day job. But like sometimes, you know, you gotta live your life and you gotta like support your family or whatever else is going on. So like that is reality. And the other thing like is that, you know, that you have to devote your life to music, and then like if you don't make it, then that's over and you need to like put that aside and like do another career. But like really you can keep music in your life. You don't need, it doesn't need to be one or the other. So I think that's something for musicians to know.
All right, so I made a contract with myself when I was 18 that this life I was gonna play music, and I went to jazz school with Jason here,
met him in 97.
Hi.
And we had a couple teachers. One teacher, Mark Torak, said play this next solo like it's gonna be the last solo you ever play. Right, so I had a recontract with myself. I was like, okay. And then I hear these terms like, this guy's a lifer. Someone called me a lifer once. I didn't think of myself as a lifer. I'm like, oh, I'm a lifer. And then I was like, okay, so I made a secret contract with myself. I'm gonna do this for my whole life. So the thing I've never admitted to anyone is that I never had a plan B, and that was on purpose. Because if you have a safety net, it's nice to know that this is what you're gonna do, whether I become poor, whether I become rich. It doesn't matter. The money thing doesn't matter. You meet people like Jason, you meet people like the other people I play with, that's what it's about. You can't take that away from me. You know? I could be suffering, I could be starving, I'm still gonna jam with my buddies. And that's what I do with this life.
That you're completely 100% prepared for what you're about to become involved with or perform or rehearse. I'm a bass player and I've been lucky to play with a lot of different kinds of bands and a lot of different genres, and oftentimes people have said, hey, do you want to do this electronic group or this reggae fusion group? And I'm always like, yes, let's do it. But then what I'm not admitting is I might be thinking, I wonder how, like I've never done that before. I wonder how I should approach it, or, you know, if I'm gonna be able to do a great job, but I still go in 100% and do my best, and the result is always becoming a much greater and experienced, well-rounded musician.
I guess just like the feeling of creating something with other friends and stuff like that, you know, just being with a group of people, just having fun. You know, letting things go naturally, having fun, like, seriously, that's it. Awesome.
The answer would be, it's not all fun and games. It's a lot of hard work.
That's what I was saying.
I would say it's the extreme ups and downs, because I feel like when you're on the stage, at least for me, it's just you're putting more than just like the music into it. You're putting your full energy into it, and for me, I'm a horn player, so I'm physically putting air into it, kind of using my entire body to do it. So at the end of the set, it's kind of like you're completely exhausted and drained, you just want to sleep. So I feel like playing shows every day, a lot of times it's just these highs and then lows, and it's kind of tiring after a while, like just every day just doing that, you know, the excitement of being on stage and then just wanting to sleep and not talk to anyone. So I would say it's probably that.
And your name and band?
I'm Liam Robertson. I play saxophone. I freelance. I play for a lot of different bands, but today I'm here with Tunnel Vision.
How powerful music really is, how much it can break down to anyone from anything. It's frequencies, vibrations, and it can bring up an emotion or a feeling something you can't remember. Don't tell you how powerful it is.
I'd say that about 90% of your brain space is taken up by wondering where the next toilet you're gonna be able to use is. And then maybe like 5% food, and then the last 5% music. And that's what touring is essentially.
One thing that you don't know about being a musician is, to be honest, everybody thinks backstage is the coolest place to be. It's really not, and the bathrooms aren't as good as like the front of the house. Like, they're all porta johns too, so you're not really missing out. So stay in the front of the house and enjoy the show.
Name?
Carl Zagbadas from Dirty Ends.
Hello, my name is Chris Forte. I'm the bass from Sierra Lane. And the thing that most people don't talk about being a musician is that it's a blessing and a curse. Mostly a blessing, but the cursey side kind of sucks ass. So if you're miserable, if you're doing it, and you're miserable, you're not. So I just want to fucking do it. Happy to be here.
All the little addictions that come with it, like having to go to a show to see some music, or having an extensive guitar collection, or buying a keyboard for no good reason other than it's on sale. I think that's one of the things nobody speaks about.
Okay, so something no one admits about being a musician is that it gets really hectic on the road. There's a lot of travel, sometimes back and forth. Every night is a brand new bed. A lot of people say it's the glamour and the vibe on the stage, but it gets hectic. But it's really good to come out and perform for y'all. But hey, I gotta admit, it's hectic.
So for me, it's that like I have no clue what I'm doing. Like micro, I learned and I know like what I'm doing, but macro, zero clue. Like day to day, fucking nothing. When I'm on stage playing, used to think about it, now nothing. Like blank mind. So yeah, I maybe other musicians do, but I have no clue what I'm doing most of the time.
So what the thing that people don't realize about choosing to be a musician is that in a lot of people's worlds, it feels like the world doesn't want you to do this because there's no security. Whether it's from your parents, or whether it's from your school, or whether it's from just society in general, I feel like there's a lack of appreciation of the service that singer-songwriters bring, and there's no security blanket. So, like, it's all on you. It's all on you.
I feel like no one admits it. Practice is kind of fun. Practice might be more fun than playing a show, to be honest. Yeah.
Well, for me personally, on the drums, I don't know if this is my fault, but on my darkest days, I cannot hear anything that anyone else is doing in the band. Luckily, I know the songs at this point, but I can never hear.
Something no one admits about things. I would say a lot of people think that you have it a lot easy on the road. I think it's like a whole big party. And I think it's all fun and games. And you just have like this unfair life. It's like, oh, I have to go to work every day and you guys just get to do this. But the reality of it is you are sitting in a, well, at least us, we're not in a bus tour this time, but we're in a van and trailer. And you are literally like sitting, trying to catch some sleep on a bench in a Ford van, driving for like 6 hours a day and just living out of your suitcase basically. You get to the hotel and you pull out your suitcase and that's your life. Your whole life is in there. And you have to just do that every single night for weeks on end. So it's not as glamorous as a lot of people think it is. You know, it takes actually a lot of patience and determination to not like crack up. It's just night after night after night after night. So I think that's one of the big misconceptions people have. It's not all glamorous as it really is hyped up to be. Sure, we do have fun, you know, we have a good time at night and get to hang with our fans and do things like that. But the most part, you're sitting in a van driving for miles and miles on end with nothing in sight through Texas or freaking Alabama or Missouri. You never stop there in the States. And that's life on the road. It's just you and your buddies. Dealing with each other, living out of your suitcase, going from hotel to hotel.
I would say how much work and commitment goes into it. It's a lifestyle commitment, and you just gotta stay dedicated to it your whole life.
I think staying disciplined and practicing. It's easy to practice when you're a beginner, but as you continue to grow as a musician, it's hard to stay disciplined on that practice. Well, my band Roots of Creation has started implementing drum solos, and I am not a soloist, so that's probably been the most difficult thing for me. Just on the fly solos, like we have a 3-minute solo to go into the second set. I never know what to do, so it's been a struggle for me, but pushing through it.
Name and band.
Brendan Dillon of Roots of Creation. I play the drums.
I mean, we talk about it, but like not overly publicly, but how hard of it is to do. The touring, the show to show, the night after night, the overnight drives, the little pay when you're starting out, the trying to find time to sleep, trying to find time to eat. Touring's a grind. It's a lot of fun, but it's a grind.
How rewarding it is, honestly. I mean, people say it's rewarding, but like seeing all those smiling faces out there singing along to the song and dancing and everything, it's just another feeling. It can't be matched.
What is something that no one admits about being a musician? Something I don't want to admit is that we I don't know. I don't even know where to go with this. We probably all have something deep in our lives that makes us all act just a little different, just a little bit out, just a little bit misfit, just a little bit of that's how we connect into the world. And I think the thing that we don't like to admit is that we all I don't know, I should think deeper, right? I should think deeper. So long. Now I know he's working on this, and I'm
that's a really good question.
I'm really good at misdirection, you know. That one of the deep secrets about musicians and artists is that we're excellent at misdirecting things. And that's a deep secret of mine, and I'll never tell anybody else that.
So here's one thing that I can contest to all you guys that you guys don't know about most artists. Most of us wash most of our clothes in the sink. So it doesn't matter if it's a pair of socks or if it's like a dirty ass pair of drawers or something. My point is, you gotta do what you gotta do. But most people don't tell you, either we throw our clothes in the trash and have to get new ones, or we're constantly washing our clothes in sinks or buckets. That happens, that's a real thing.
Or you're gonna live with the smell of being a musician, and no one likes that smell. No one.
Yeah, no one likes that smell. I mean, I'll be real with you. There's a lot of intricacies about being an artist, I guess. You know, there's a different, you know, you come to a different kind of lifestyle compared to the norm, I guess. So there's a lot of little hidden pop-ups that happen that you kind of just in the moment roll with. So I guess, you know, one of the things that I would find probably the most quirky with most of us is that every single one of us is different. So you'll find a an intricate factor with every single artist that does have a variable, but every single variable, you don't know where it falls into the wheel well of, if it's like water falling through the cracks or whatnot. So, I mean, you know, there's a lot of personability with a lot of artists. So I think the biggest thing is if you focus in on writing per artist and what they put out and whatnot, you kind of get a deep sense of where they're coming from. So that's not necessarily something that's explained to the public unless you're listening to the music and defining it by the rules of how they go out and push themselves out to the people and play their shows and interact with everybody. So that's, you know, unless you're really paying focus, you really got to, you know, intricately like break that down. So
probably that as you are traveling on the road, there are immense mental pressures from, you know, just the everyday dealings with your mates and, you know, the pressures of the shows. And there's a lot of, like, I call it mental yoga that I do personally in order to try and stay on a level, even kind of ground. Because other than that, you might really lose your cool, lose yourself, just something that definitely you don't want to do.
Okay, something that no one admits, being a musician, the rough roads. People normally see the lights, but they don't really see the behind the scenes. Yeah, that's pretty much it.
Name and band?
Clive, I sing harmonies for Calibuds.
Something no one admits about being a musician is you have to live in your parents' house for a really long time. But also, you know, every day is a grind. Everyone thinks it's always a party, but it's a lot of hard work, traveling, and sacrifice.
No one admits about being a musician. That's a good question.
No one admits.
That's a tough one.
I mean, I think everybody thinks we all live like a very glorious lifestyle. And I think that the like hour, 2 hours we're on stage makes the rest of the hurry up and wait like worth it, but
yeah, a lot of waiting.
A lot of just sitting around kind of filled with anxiety, ready to
and
try and get out
of musicians. Are not people you want waiting around.
No,
like, we don't do well. With waiting around.
Yeah,
like, when we have to wait around, shit, we get into trouble.
Yeah,
but our job is 90% waiting around.
That's so, you're right.
Right?
Yeah.
So we have to
idle hands.
Yeah. Never, and we're not like bankers. We're not like disciplined motherfuckers.
No,
you know what I mean? We're artists, but yet we have to fight against this waiting time.
And I think if you showed everybody the real deal backstage of how it all is on a full tour, everyone sees the cool shit, right? Because that's what we put out.
Yeah.
But if people really watched the real, like, struggles that we all have to kind of deal with being on the road, I don't think anybody would be like, that's what I want to do. Like, that's what's up.
Because now I have my answer.
You know what I'm saying? Like, we're blessed, but at the same time, like any other thing you do in life, there's a bit of a sacrifice to have the moment, right? Like, and the sacrifice is, you know, that's what we all like accept.
Yeah.
And it makes the moment that much better when we get it.
You know,
because we don't always get it. That's the thing.
Yeah.
Not every show is great. And that's real. You win some, you lose some. That's facts.
That's his answer. You win some, you lose some.
Love it.
Yeah.
Name and band, so I can label it.
Oh, yeah, yeah. I'm Mahali from Mahali and Twiddle.
Awesome.
Hell yeah. All right, I'm going to try to give you a super deep answer. Ready?
Okay.
Ask me the question.
What's something no one admits about being a musician?
I think your question is off. I can't believe you're making a documentary about this question. Like, the fact that the assumption that there is a one, well, I guess that's the point of your movie, is that for each musician it's different. Do you think there's gonna be like one common thing?
As far as
one main thing that every Like, you think, like, there'll be 10% of your answers are gonna be like a smattering of like random things, but like, do you feel like 80% of your answers are gonna be the same answer?
I think so. Like, the moral of.
Let me ask you then. What is the answer? Like, what is the thing that most people say? Let me ask you. Give me the camera.
Oh my.
Let's get you on this film.
What is this? What is this?
No. Anyone do that?
See, I'm Maras Yahoo. I do this. What is the number? I'm not regular. What is the number one answer that you get from musicians when you ask them, what is the one thing that a musician will not, not admit to? Something like that.
What's something no one admits about being a musician?
Admits. What is something, what is the number one answer? Is it the bathroom?
I can't believe you said that. I got a couple of those. But that's not the number one.
What's number one?
The number one conveyed in a message as to what's something no one admits about being a musician is, it's not all that glamorous, and what goes on behind the scenes is not what you think is actually happening.
So what do you think, like, as an are you a musician?
I am. I play guitar.
Do you play concerts?
No, I don't, but I am a live mural artist performer.
Okay, so in terms of playing live music in front of fans, that's not you, right?
Right.
So my question is, what is the main thing that they say is that it's not that glorious, right?
Being a perfectionist is definitely a downfall in the process. I'm always constantly feeling like I need to perform and do my very best and deliver my very best, and it can be stressful because sometimes it gets me feeling out of alignment, but then I need to get back to the drawing board, back into myself within it, remember, why am I doing this? What is my intention, and who am I really?
What is your intention?
My intention in doing what I do, like with live art performance or?
With this.
That's a great question. All right. I hated being on camera because I was always a shy child, and I always admired people who were courageous enough, bold enough to speak in front of others and share with them their deepest vulnerability. I remember doing that as a child. It was one of the most traumatic experiences for
really?
Me.
Really? What happened?
It was.
What happened?
I remember it started in second grade when I got called out to read a book in front of the class, and I froze, and I felt judged by my teacher, and my classmates laughed. And from there on, like, that bothered me to the point where I got called into the office and got...
You got in trouble for that?
I got it. Well, not in trouble. They were concerned, and they started to evaluate me as having mental issues. So they took me. They sent me to a psychiatrist because I was not the outspoken type. And when I went to a
you were introverted and quiet.
Exactly. Yeah, I was totally okay with that. But then I felt like something was wrong as soon as people made me feel judged. So.
Wow.
I went to a psychiatrist. I remember going to a psychiatrist, and I felt like I didn't need to go to a psychiatrist, but I didn't know how to express that being introvert was okay and comforting in my well-being. But I felt like I had to go anyway because I was a child and, you know, do as the grown-ups say. So I remember the doctor asking me questions, difficult questions like, how's my upbringing in my home? Am I getting abused? Am I getting... am I being abused some type of way that's causing me to be silent and introverted? And I thought that felt really weird. And once that evaluation finished, he gifted me a stuffed kitty animal. And I remember that stuffed animal was a close thing to me. It reminded
me. Wow.
I don't know. It was... From there on, I had an imprint in me that it was not okay to be vulnerable and to open myself up to people.
It wasn't okay?
Yeah, I felt like it was
because
not okay.
Because of the stuffed animal?
Well, no, not because of the stuffed animal. I remember the stuffed animal as...
I feel like the stuffed animal was kind of a nice side thing.
It was. It was comforting to me. It was like, it's like a favorite stuffed animal at that point because it reminded me of that traumatic experience. It was a weird connection to it, but it was like my safety net in remembering where I came from. And every time I get asked this question of how did I come about coming from a place of being an introverted to to being able to do projects like this where I am witnessing other people being bold, courageous, and open with their vulnerability, it brings me back to that memory. And
oh, wow.
It inspires me to, and it reminds me that we're all human. There's a deeper aspect within ourselves that makes us feel like human. And no matter what goes on beyond our assumption, there's this vulnerable child within all of us that asks us to come out and be open and embrace ourselves with the story we have created. That was healing.
I can't believe you did that.
I gotta give you a hug.
That was beautiful.
Oh, wow. I've never had that happen. Thank you. I am just mind blown with your approach on that. That was very clever, and that was very clever. That was beautiful.
Beautiful.